Hello, and thank you for joining me today. I am Jedi Master Josh, and today I will be discussing the issue of immigration and terrorism. Two hot-button issues that have come together in recent discussions about the border, how to control the border, what to do about possible terrorism in terms of terrorists coming across the border. And it sort of came to a head in this this interview that Sarah Sanders did with Chris Wallace on Fox News. Chris Wallace grilled Sarah Sanders about claims that she made regarding terrorism, and I want to play that clip for you real quick.
The president talks about terrorists potentially coming across the border, and here is Secretary of Homeland Security Nielsen. Take a look.
CBP has stopped over 3,000 what we call special interest aliens trying to come into the country on the southern border. Those are aliens who the intel community has identified are of concern.
But special interest aliens are just people who come from countries that have ever produced a terrorist. They're not terrorists themselves. And the State Department says that there is, quote, their words, no credible evidence of any terrorists coming across the border from Mexico.
We know that roughly nearly 4,000 known or suspected terrorists come into our country illegally. And we know that our most vulnerable point of entry is at our southern border.
Because I know this statistic. I didn't know if you were going to use it, but I studied up on this. Do you know where those 4,000 people come or where they're captured? Airports.
Not always, but airports. Certainly a large
number. The State Department says there hasn't been any terrorists that they found coming across the southern border.
So, as you heard there, in that clip, Sarah Sanders made the claim that around close to 4,000 suspected or known terrorists were apprehended attempting to make it into the United States, with Chris Wallace pushing back and saying that those individuals were apprehended at airports and were not apprehended at the border. So, what's going on? So, are they coming in through the border? Are terrorists attempting to come in through the border? Or are they all attempting to fly? I thought they were trying to fly planes into buildings, but apparently they try to fly planes into our country first and then fly them into buildings. But, you know, I guess that's just the way it works. So, he pushes back on her claim, and the thing is, Chris Wallace is right. Chris Wallace is right that, in fact, the near 4,000 people that Sarah Sanders was referring to were indeed apprehended at airports, the vast majority of them, that were known or suspected terrorists. The thing is, there are several numbers, and these numbers get conflated. The 4,000 number that she was talking about were indeed known or suspected terrorists that were caught at airports, attempting to enter the United States illegally. Now, there is another claim of people caught at the border. That number is also around 3,000. It's around the same amount, but it's a different number entirely. The 3,000 figure that was put forward by Department of Homeland Security Secretary Christian Nielsen are individuals that are known as SIAs, or special interest aliens. So these are people who are coming from countries, as Chris Wallace noted, that do have known terrorist activity. There are terrorist hotbeds. And because of that, these individuals are categorized as special interest aliens. That does not, as a matter of fact, mean that they are terrorists. But the thing is, of those people, so these are two separate numbers, the near 4,000 that Sarah Sanders said are people that get apprehended at terrorists. The 3,000 that Christian Nielsen was referring to are people that were apprehended at the border, but these are not attempting to enter illegally, mind you, but these are not people that are necessarily terrorists. But are there no terrorists in those numbers? Well, no, there actually are some terrorists in those numbers. So let's go through it. PolitiFact recently rated as mostly true a statement from Florida Senator Ron DeSantis when he was quoted as saying, recent reports state the U.S. Customs and Border Protection has apprehended several members of known Islamic terrorist organizations crossing the southern border in recent years. The The Politico article then continues to say, when we contacted DeSantis's office, a spokesman pointed us to a 2015 article from the Houston Chronicle as the source of his statement. The newspaper published a report for elected officials from the Texas Department of Public Safety that said shifting law enforcement sources to protect the border led to crime problems in other parts of the state. But the report also said that authorities had detained several people with ties to Islamic terrorist organizations, a point the Washington Post highlighted in a follow-up. The Texas agency told the Post that the Chronicle had not properly obtained the report, which they said wasn't meant for the public. Texas reported 439 cases of people from these countries, including Afghanistan, Iraq, Iran, Lebanon, Libya, Pakistan, and Syria, either caught crossing the border or presenting themselves at ports of entry without permission to enter. The report also said authorities had reported 143, quote, land border crossing encounters with watch-listed individuals in southwest border states between November 2013 and July 2014. These encounters, the article continues, included one with an alleged member of Al-Shabaab, the Somali-based group responsible for the 2013 mall massacre in Nairobi, Kenya. In June 2014, he said he had been trained for a suicide attack in Mogadishu, but escaped and surrendered to African Union troops who stopped the attack. That account was unverified, and the person sought immigration benefits from the United States, the report said. The would-be senator Beto O'Rourke from Texas also got a false rating from Politico for saying, quote, precisely zero terrorist groups or terror plots have ever been connected with the U.S.-Mexico border to do harm to people within the United States. So there are, in fact, people that do attempt to cross the border that do, in fact, have ties to terrorism. Now, that being said, as Chris Wallace pointed out, these are two separate numbers, and the vast majority of the people that get apprehended that are known or suspected terrorists do, in fact, get apprehended at airports. But, again, there are a small number that do get caught at the border. The House Homeland Security Committee majority came out with a report recently titled Stopping Terrorist Travel Through Illicit Pathways to the Homeland. In this report, they highlighted several examples of individuals with known terror relations, known terrorist ties, that were, in fact, caught either at the border or caught attempting to smuggle people in through the border. And I'm going to name a couple of those examples that they put forward. One being, and I'm going to butcher these names, not on purpose, but, you know, hey, they're terrorists, so who cares? Mohamed Aldari. From Jordan, who in 2018 was arrested at the JFK International Airport for conspiracy to illegally smuggle special interest aliens from Yemen across the U.S.-Mexico border into Texas, citizens of Jordan and legal residents of Mexico. Then we've got Sharaft Ali Khan from Pakistan in 2017, sentenced to 31 months in prison for a leadership role in a human smuggling network after pleading guilty to conspiracy to smuggle undocumented migrants from Pakistan with potential terrorism ties into the U.S. for profit. Abdullah Omar Fidsi from Somalia in 2013 was sentenced to 8 years in prison for conspiracy to make a false statement during terrorism investigation and conspiracy to obstruct an immigration proceeding. He made false statements on his asylum application to improve his claim and conceal his ties and support for Al-Shabaab. Ahmed Muhammad Dakane, from Somalia in 2011, was sentenced to 10 years in prison for two counts of making false statements under penalty of perjury to federal authorities concerning his association with terrorist organizations after pleading guilty to lying on his asylum application. Member of Al-Barak, Al-Ittihad, Al-Islami, AIAI for short, much easier to say, both designated by the Department of Treasury as Specially Designated Global Terrorists, SDGT, with links to Al-Qaeda, also ran a large-scale human smuggling enterprise in Brazil and crossed the U.S.-Mexico border illegally. Mohammed Youssef Kourani from Lebanon in 2005, sentenced to 4.5 years in prison for raising money for Hezbollah after pleading guilty to conspiring to support a terrorist organization known as a fighter, recruiter, and fundraiser for Hezbollah, raised over $40,000. Also paid a Beirut consular officer $3,000 for a Mexican visa and an additional $4,000 to be smuggled across the U.S.-Mexico border. So, in fact, there are multiple cases, as we can see here, of individuals who do indeed have terror ties who are attempting to cross the border or attempting to smuggle people across the border who would potentially as well have terrorist ties themselves. And again, special interest aliens, the vast majority of the 3,000 that Christian Nielsen, DHS secretary, pointed out are special interest aliens. That does not mean that they have any terrorist ties, but some of those individuals do. And again, the vast majority do indeed get caught at airports. And that 4,000 number and the 3,000 number from Sarah Sanders and Christian Nielsen respectively are indeed two different numbers, and that is very important to remember. It's also important to keep in mind that much of this information much of the relevant information is classified because of the sensitive terror-related material. Obviously, we don't actually have access to much of the relevant information that would, you know, allow us to actually know the full extent of the border crossings or attempted border crossings by these terrorist-related individuals. The Washington Examiner noted that the investigative report from the House Homeland Security Security Committee cited Mexico's findings that within the caravans, the recent caravan from Honduras, recently, Mexico has stepped up its efforts to combat the migrant caravans coming in from Honduras, which has included several SIAs and potentially KSTs traveling towards the U.S. border, said the report in a reference to, quote, special interest aliens and known or suspected terrorists. So there we have examples of individuals within these large migrant caravans who indeed do have ties to terrorism in one way or the other. The Express in 2015 wrote an article where it quoted an ISIS operative who was speaking on condition of anonymity, who said, quote, they are going like refugees, and goes on to say, two Turkish refugee smugglers backed up the claims made by the ISIS Syrian operative, who was saying that these people are coming in as refugees. He said, quote, I'm sending some fighters who want to go and visit their families, others just go to Europe to be ready. So indeed, in Europe, where you've got much friendlier, more relaxed policies towards immigration and towards people coming in from areas like Syria through their refugee programs, these programs are indeed being abused by terrorist organizations, and it is, again, something that has been admitted by people within those very terror organizations. It's also very important to know that when you're talking about terrorism, you're talking about an outsized threat. So even if it's true that many numbers of people get caught at airports, for example, and some individuals do get caught at the border attempting to cross with these terror ties, many of them do get caught. We don't know, obviously, the individuals that didn't get caught crossing through the border, especially, because how would we know? But even if it's a small number of people that do make it through, or a small number that even attempt to make it through, it's worth remembering that it was only 19 individuals that committed the most heinous terror attack in the United States, the 9/11 terror attacks that killed roughly 3,000 people. Also, when you look at lone wolf terrorist attacks, they can be incredibly damaging, and that is a single person who's able to kill, you know, dozens of people in many cases. I mean, if you look at the Pulse nightclub shooting, for example, there were dozens of people who were killed in that unfortunate incident. So is that 4,000 number that Sarah Sanders put forward misleading? Yes. Yes, it actually is misleading. And I think it's completely fair to say that. However, the point that is important is that any number of these individuals could cause a significant amount of damage. So there's no need to actually to overestimate and to try to conflate these numbers, because even if you're only talking about a handful of people who are attempting to cross through our border, that is still a problem. That is still a huge problem, and it's something that should indeed be addressed. And there are individuals out there in the media right now who are attempting to say that there are in fact no individuals who have ever been caught attempting to cross her border with terrorist ties. That is simply not true in the slightest. Now, a real number, a closer estimate to what we're probably seeing at our southern border is probably closer to about 20 people or so a year on average, either attempting to cross or heading for the border. These statistics coming from the CIS, the Center for Immigration Studies. So, again, it was only 19 people, a relative handful of individuals, who were able to pull off the biggest terrorist attack ever in the United States, killing, again, roughly 3,000 people. An absolutely devastating attack on our homeland, something that has absolutely, absolutely shaped our society in many ways. Absolutely, the idea that we need to have border security for, at least in part, preventing terrorism is an absolutely valid and absolutely worthwhile argument, and it is something that absolutely should happen. Not, again, only for that reason, but for the cornucopia of reasons that having a open border is, you know, I think pretty obviously not a good idea. So I just wanted to sort of tackle that real quick, because I've seen a lot of sort of false narratives floating around surrounding that particular exchange between Chris Wallace and Sarah Sanders, and I kind of wanted to sort of hopefully clarify that a little bit. And again, there are not 4,000 Osama bin Laden's attempting to walk across our southern border every year or anything like that. Again, the number is far smaller than that. And again, these are the people that we know of. So we don't actually know if there are people in the country, because if they made it in illegally, well, we wouldn't know that until it's too late. So yes, we should secure our border for multiple reasons, one of which being the potential for terrorism and terrorists. So with that, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, if you found it informative, please, share, like, all that good stuff. And with that, I hope you have a wonderful day. And as always, may the force be with you.